Hello guys, welcome to another video. This video is experimental and informative. So let's unbox the Racerstar brushless motor which I got at a price of $10. This motor doesn't come up with the bullet connector. I connected them earlier and repacked them for unboxing. This is the Racerstar branding and this is the model number, which is BR2207S, and this motor is of 2500 kV. The Best Buy link is in the description. I'll be testing it with a 5-inch propeller, which is recommended in its datasheet. Though it's not recommended, I will also be testing it with a 6-inch propeller. And since I'm doing a thrust test on the motor, so I'll be testing my old 1000 kV motor. I'll be testing it with a 10-inch propeller and an 8-inch propeller. But before proceeding, I have to make a test rig. So let's make the test rig. These are the 3D printed parts required to make the test rig, along with 3 PVC tubes of half an inch in diameter. The length of the two pipes is 24 cm and that of the other one is 25 cm. I have already drilled the holes in pipe by placing them in their mounts and drilling from the above. The 3D printed parts are of high quality and strength, as I have printed them with 0.2 mm layer height and 30% infill. Now I will attach all the parts together with M3 size screws of different length. So first take the short tube and place it inside its mount. Align the screw holes of both the parts. Then after aligning, insert two 40mm screws into it and tighten it. Then carefully place the bottom part and repeat the same procedure. Once done, the vertical arm is ready and then we can make the second vertical arm. I have already assembled the second arm to save time. Now we will make the tilting arm which will hold the motor. So grab the pipe and insert the top mount into it. Then after inserting all these screws and tightening them, our tilting arm is completed. Now for the frictionless rotation, I am attaching two 625ZZ bearings on each side. Now all the arms have been completed, it's time to attach them together. I am using an M5 bolt of 70mm length along with two washers and a nut to connect all the three arms. So first take the vertical arm and then insert the bolt into the center hole. Then place it horizontally and insert the washer on the bolt. I am using a washer between the vertical arm and the rotating arm to eliminate the friction losses caused by rubbing of two parts. While placing the second vertical arm, insert a nut into the hexagon groove provided in the upper part of it. After attaching all the arms, the assembly will be ready. Recheck the movement of the rotating arm by dropping it off. You can adjust the fit by tightening or loosening the bolt. Now this part will be attached to the pulley. Make sure to print it sideways like this, as all the horizontal and vertical forces will be acting on it. But if you print it in a vertical direction, the layer might be separated because of the vertical force. Now I have attached the pulley with an M3 screw of 20mm length. To mount all the pieces together, I'll be using a plywood piece of 40cm length and 25cm width. I have already connected 4 shoes at the bottom of the plywood. I drilled all the holes earlier. Now place the assembled parts on top of the plywood and attach them with M3 screws of 20mm length. Now the test rig has been completed. But the problem with that is the rotating arm doesn't have any restrictions. So as to restrict its motion, I have already designed grooves in it to insert a 3mm shaft. So just insert the M3 screw into the groove and restrict the motion of the center arm by 30 degrees. Now to mount the motor with the rotating arm, we'll be using this mount. So I'll grab the brushless motor and place it on this mount while aligning the screw holes. Fix the motor with 4 M3 screws of 8mm length. So our motor mount is completed and it's time to assemble it on the test rig. So here is the test rig and I've already connected all the electrical equipment. I'm using a 40 ampere ESC which is connected to a wattmeter. And here is the servo tester which will be used to throttle the motor. Now to fix the motor mount on the central arm, we have to remove this universal mount. After removing it, just place the motor mount and fix it with 2 M3 screws of 40mm length. Now connect the wire of the motor to the ESC. I'll be using a high strength rope with 2 loops at the end to transfer the motion. So just wrap the rope around the arm as shown and insert any smaller loops from the other one to form a bigger loop as shown. Then pass the other rope end through the pulley. I am using a spring balance of 50 kg limit to calculate the thrust of the motor. So place it between the two vertical arms and use any shaft, like I am using a wrench to hold it in place. Then grab the other loop of the rope and insert it into the hook of the spring balance. Now the setup of the test rig has been completed. Now it's time to mount the propeller. So first I used a 5-inch propeller and mounted it with the motor. Then check the connection properly, and when everything is perfect, place the rig aside for testing. I am connecting an 11.1 volt 3000 mAh battery. And when you connect it, you will hear beep sound from the motor, which indicates that the motor is ready to fly. Wear safety glasses for eye protection. So switch on the spring balance and begin the test. The maximum thrust recorded was 595 grams at 23.12 ampere. When we add the ideal thrust required to lift the arm, that is 95 grams, then we get the total thrust of 690 grams at 23.12 ampere. Now I will replace the 5-inch propeller with a 6-inch one. But before proceeding, I would like to show you the temperature of the motor. And that comes around to be 41 degrees Celsius. Now just loose the nut with a wrench and replace the propeller. Now connect the battery and start the test. Maximum thrust is 805 grams at 34.30 ampere, and when we add the ideal thrust, then we get the total thrust of 900 grams at 34.30 ampere. Well, this time the motor is hotter than the previous time, and its temperature is 48 degrees Celsius. So this time the thrust was increased by 210 grams, but also the current consumption has increased by 11.18 ampere. We'll talk about this later in the conclusion part. Now I have attached the motor to the motor mount, and it's time to connect the propeller. I am using a 10-inch propeller, and make sure to fix this O-ring in the propeller before placing it on the motor. This ring prevents vibration as it reduces the clearance between the propeller and its adapter. So here is an example of a propeller without the O-ring. Though you cannot see the propeller, you can feel the vibration from its sound. So it's better to avoid this thing. Now connect the propeller with its adapter, then fix it on the motor and tighten it with a plier. Now connect the motor wires to the ESC. Attach the spring balance and then we'll begin the test. Now connect the battery and after the beep sounds, start the throttle. During the test, I found out that the test rig was not stable and it was moving. So to eliminate this movement, I have placed a brake on the test rig to increase its weight. And don't get confused that it's moving because of the vibration. It's because previously the thrust force was acting under a diameter of 5 inches, so the air was directly hitting the test rig platform. But in this case, the thrusted air has a bigger diameter because of the 10-inch propeller. So it hits the main table and causes the movement. Now I have connected the battery to test the thrust. Thrust is 530 grams at 12.75 ampere, and when we add the ideal thrust, then we get the total thrust of 625 grams at 12.75 ampere. Now disconnect the battery and replace the propeller with an 8-inch one. This 8-inch propeller doesn't require an O-ring and can be directly fitted to its adapter. Now connect the battery and after the motor beeps, start the throttle. max thrust is 415 grams at 9.60 ampere. And when we add the ideal thrust, then we get the total thrust of 510 grams at 9.60 ampere. Now the thrust test has been completed and it's time for the conclusion. The above performance chart is received from the thrust test and the bottom one was provided by the manufacturer of the Racerstar motor. Now talking about the Racerstar motor, the 5-inch propeller produces 690 grams of thrust at 23.12 ampere, while the 6-inch propeller produces 900 grams of thrust at 34.30 ampere. Though the 6-inch propeller produces more thrust as compared to the 5-inch one, but it's less efficient as compared to the 5-inch propeller. Maybe this must be the reason why the manufacturer doesn't recommend a 6-inch propeller. Now we are talking about the 1000 kV motor. The 10-inch propeller produces 625 grams of thrust at 12.75 ampere, while the 8-inch propeller produces 510 grams of thrust at 9.60 ampere. Though the 8-inch produces less thrust as compared to the 10-inch one, but it is efficient as compared to the 10-inch one. And in fact, the 1000 kV motor is much more efficient than the Racerstar motor, or we can say that they are twice as efficient as the Racerstar motor. But each motor has its own application. Racerstar motors are designed for racing drones and thus gives a quick thrust in a very short period of time. That's why they consume so much current and hence drains the battery quickly. But if you want to make an economical drone, or we can say a drone which has a long lasting time of flight, then you can go for a higher efficient motor or a motor that consumes less ampere. So here the thrust test is over and you can see there is a slight difference between my performance chart and the manufacturer one. It's because the ideal conditions at both the places are different. My old battery could be one of the reasons. So from the next time I'll be using my 8000 mAh battery which can supply a continuous current and also I don't have to charge it multiple times. And if you stayed this long in this video, so there's a spoiler for you for my next video. I'm working on an 80mm ducted fan and checking its thrust. Hope you enjoyed this video, so thanks everyone for watching and don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any suggestions, then please comment in the comment section.